Praise the Lord, everyone.
Praise
God's
the Lord.
Grace, love, and mercy is so great. If you'd all bow your heads for the opening prayer. Dear Heavenly Father, we thank you for this day. A beautiful day. Any day is a beautiful day. We thank you for all your love, mercy, and your greatness. We ask that you come into this service and fill this house with your spirit. We ask all this in Jesus Christ's holy name. Amen.
Amen.
Also, if you have an ailment or you have something that's weighing lay on your heart that you really need somebody to pray for you, the altar is always open. And we have plenty of people that will come up and pray for you. Even me. A few months ago, well, almost a year, I knelt down at that altar. Didn't embarrass me. No one's going to be judgmental here. No one. If you feel that you need to, throughout the whole service and the same, feel free to come up. Is there any request or testimonies out there among everyone that's here? Well, I guess I got, Harold.
I want to thank God that our pastor is on the hill, on the mend.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Stand up, Jim.
Nothing but answered prayer.
Yes. That's it. Praise the Lord.
A major heart attack.
Major heart attack. This man comes home from work, tells his wife he ain't feeling well, lays down, has a major heart attack, flighted to Toledo. It's been what, 2 weeks?
Three
weeks. And here he is, sitting in the pew. That's the Lord. That's the Lord. And my testimony is, a lot of you don't know me, and the ones that do, I battled that diabetes. And I've been battling a diabetic ulcer on the bottom of my foot. And I think it's been almost 6 months that I've been battling this. And it's almost completely healed.
Amen.
I had to battle MRSA in it. Got rid of that. The good Lord's great. And after that, they thought there was osteomyelitis in the bone marrow. And the good Lord healed that.
Praise God.
And because I'm a diabetic, I also have diabetic retinopathy. Thank goodness my wife knows how to print in bigger print, but I don't need it as much as I did anymore. This eye, my left eye, was the worst. I read 2200 was the best I could read with this eye. And I gave it to the Lord and gave it to the doctor. Later, I was reading 2080.
Amen.
Amen. A couple months later, I'm reading 2070. Hey, thanks. Was just there 2 weeks ago, and the doctor come in, and he's all giddy and everything else. And I said, what? I said, I don't think I read that one. He says, you want a bet? He said, it's healing after 3 years. And I said, the big guy upstairs, he says, it's something. He says, now I don't feel so bad about doing surgery on your eye. He says, you read 2060. From 2200 to 2060, thank you, Lord. Thank you, thank you, thank you.
Amen.
He's good. He's good to each and every one of us.
Always.
Well, since we just had a testimony and no one that could think of having any prayer requests.
Thank God for Sister Custer, and thank you for your prayers. She's on the mend. She's in the nursing home. She's sitting up. She's viable. She's talking. She's speaking. She's having a good time.
Fantastic.
Meeting visitors.
Amen. 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 Well, I have a scripture here that I want to read to you. And it's, "For he hath made him to be sin for us, who knew no sin, that we might be made the righteous of God in him." We see here a metaphor, a form of figurative expression used to emphasize a point that Jesus became sin. More literally, he became a sin offering for each and every one of us. But a sin offering was that on which sin of others were symbolically placed. In Jesus' case, our guilt was literally placed on him when he came as the Lamb of God to take away the sin of the world. And if we bow our heads, dear dying Lamb, you took the guilt of our sins on yourself, and you were treated by the Father as if guilty yourself for our sins. He turned away his face, and you bore God's wrath against sin as if you had been sin itself. When you hung on Calvary's tree, may we never forget the great sacrifice you made for us. May we never forget the gift of your perfect righteousness. Amen. And if everybody will turn to their hymnals, to page 94. Amazing Grace.
Save us far and great. Thank you.
yes, it ran a little bit quicker than I had anticipated, but okay, well, I was going to have Gene stand up and introduce our singers tonight. Oh, there he is. Well, you guys, I figured you'd be next to Marilyn. I'm sorry.
He was.
I move around, right?
Yeah.
I was going to help my friend here.
Yes.
Yes, we are blessed to have QG.
Amen.
Part of our congregation. And she just recently got married for a couple months.
Yes.
And she's all the way from China.
Amen.
So, and if you know anything about China, for her to just be in here, she'd be persecuted in a heart.
Yes, she would be.
Oh, you need that?
Praise the Lord. And I'm honored to have a friend like QG. She's been a blessing and taught us a lot about love. Right?
Yeah.
She has only been here in the United States maybe a year now. Right? About a year. Just happened to find our church down the street she lives. Walked in. And she's learning English. Right? And the way the songbooks work, that's what I got a point, right? Help her out through that. It's been a blessing. And we should all be reaching out to help others.
Amen.
Amen.
Just because you don't know them shouldn't hinder you quickly becoming somebody's friend. And
Amen.
Reaching out. It's that action, that love, that kindness is what draws people in. To ask that question. Why are you a little different? What's going on here? And then you can teach them about Jesus. And then they'll come upon that question as it states in Acts. What do I do now? Now that they've learned that they're a sinner. Right? And then we can bring another person to Jesus Christ. And they repent. And they're baptized. Receive the Holy Ghost. My sister here recently was baptized.
Amen.
Amen. What a blessing. For this evening, we're all blessed to be here. We all come together from different parts of the area. We're all here to honor Jesus. We're going to worship Him. We're going to praise His beautiful name. And there's nothing more beautiful in the name of Jesus. So let's just take a moment. Let's just pray for us this evening. Lord Jesus, we are thankful to be here together this evening to honor you, to praise you, and to worship you, Lord. We ask you to be in this sanctuary to touch each one of us as we worship together. We raise our hands, we raise our voices to you, Lord. So that we may reach out and touch others. Lord, we ask you for your presence to enter each one of our hearts. May you bless each person who stands and sings. We ask you to bless this group, Calvary's love this evening, Lord, that they will all sing in harmony for you, and we will lift you up in praise and honor. We thank you, Lord, for bringing us together. We thank you for this time. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. I'm not going to stand here too long. Standing is not what I do real good right now. But I'd like to introduce Calvary's Love. I'm going to make your way up. And let's all praise Jesus Christ together. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. God bless you, Lord.
Who is on the Lord's side?
Great, how great is God's name. We're from a little village called Doylestown, Ohio. About 2 hours somewhere. No good with directions, anybody that knows that. I don't know. But anyway, this guy right here, him and I, we have been doing ministry for many, many years. To be honest with you, at the end of this month, we're going to be celebrating. How many years, George?
That's a trick question.
Forty-two years of marriage, and we knew each other 2 years before that.
You'd be a big young man.
Any way around, anybody that knows him. Anyway, though, this is my husband, my better half, George Langley.
Thank you. Well, this beautiful person to my left. I appreciate her. Like she said, we've been traveling many, many miles, many, many years, and I really do appreciate her. There's a lot of female gospel singers out there, a lot of really good ones, but this one here, she's good, and she's my favorite. Make her welcome, Brenda Lightman. Yeah. This young man here to my right, he's been with us for about...
You need glasses.
Almost a
year. Yeah, my eyesight.
I'm not young.
He's been with us for almost a year now. He makes his home in Akron, Ohio. Him and his family, he's been singing for many, many years. Make him welcome, Mr. Jack Holchek.
And like I said, I got a couple other that we'll introduce in just a moment. But you know, have you ever opened up the newspapers? What kind of news do you see?
Not good.
Bad news. Mm-hmm. You turn on the TV, do you hear any good news?
Not very often.
Not very often. This song talks about the good news, and hopefully it'll bless you.
I'm the good.
And during that time span, my parents, which are known everywhere as Grandma and Grandpa Cole, because my son traveled with us for years, but they have been with us from the beginning. And I tell you, they enjoy what they do. And it doesn't matter what age they are. But will you two give a wave and let them know, make welcome Grandma and Grandpa Cole. We're going to have him come up here real quickly here. So real quickly, so you know a little bit about us. He was raised in a little bitty country church up in the hills of Blue Ridge, Georgia, many, many years ago. And Dad, will you please tell them, this past September, how old did you turn?
87 years old.
That's what the big can be, I'll be honest with you. It took us 2 hours to get over here. And that's not counting the time of setting up and all that. But they enjoy what they're doing. Now, Mom don't hear real good, so if you talk to her after church and she doesn't answer immediately, she don't hear real good. She's a little bit older than Dad, but I'm not allowed to tell how old. Gotta be careful there. But he's going to sing a song here, and this song talks about being able to put a smile, being able to, somebody around you to make a difference. Listen as he sings this song.
To my brother who is weaker, they think a little more of others and a little less of me.
December the 20th, 1950. Yeah, but that makes 72 years.
72 years. And as you can see, he wasn't very old at that time. He was only 15 years old. And they've been together ever since. So God can put a marriage together and it can stay together. Thank you, Dad.
One day upon a hillside, our Lord was caught away. Suddenly two men in white appeared to them that day. They said, go tell the message, declare it to all men. Get ready for the King is coming again. He's coming again.
He's coming again.
Just like he went away. He's coming again.
He's coming again.
Saints arrive on that great day. He's coming in clouds of glory. We'll shout just like he said. Get ready, for I know he's coming again. You believe that, amen? Up and down. For soon we're going home. We're gonna lay down all these burdens that we carry for so long. So keep your eyes upon the sky, for we don't know just when. But we know without a doubt he's coming again. He's coming again.
He's coming again.
Just like he went away. He's coming again.
He's coming again.
Saints arise on that great day. He's coming in clouds of glory with a shout just like he said. Get ready, for I know he's coming again. He's coming again.
He's coming again.
Just like he went away. He's coming again.
He's coming again.
Saints arise on that great day. He's coming in clouds of glory with a shout just like he said. Get ready, for I know he's coming again. He's coming in clouds of glory with a shout just like he said. Get ready, for I know he's coming again.
We're going to do one more song and then we're going to take a little break and let some of the others sing, and then we'll come back and finish up the evening there. But this song here, it talks about, how many likes bluegrass at all? Anybody?
Yeah.
We don't do bluegrass.
Yeah, this one's close, though.
Oh, okay.
It's close, and I think it's going to be as close as Calvary's Low can get to that. This one, he sings a song, The Love of Christ.
Sunrise. The lame man walks by the seashore. The deaf man hears, the broken body healed, all because of the love of Christ. No, I cannot explain it, the wondrous love of Christ. How it reaches every nation, how it saves a single life. There is hope for tomorrow, joy for my sorrow, all because of the love of Christ. all because of the love of Christ. Oh, I cannot explain it, the wondrous love of Christ. How it reaches every nation, how it saves a single life. There is hope for tomorrow, joy for my sorrow, all because of the love of Christ. No, I cannot explain it, the wondrous love of Christ. How it reaches every nation, how it saves a single life. There is hope for tomorrow, joy for my sorrow, all because of the love of Christ, all because of the love of
singers out there. Do you want to come up and set up for Randy then? You get the honor, Randy, to come up first.
I'm glad to be here today, and I enjoy the music, and I love bluegrass music too. This song is thing for all the mothers.
Amen.
And I'll pick that up and pray for my mama too. I will in heaven, and I'm about 89 years old. I get a brand new one. I was born in Detroit. And they called my mom that I fell for brand new hearing aid. So we went downtown to Detroit and I got a new hearing aid. And I hear so much noise and everything. And I've been going down the car and I come on, can I turn the radio on? And I remember it was rock and roll, but it was sweet. So when we got home, I got three brothers and my mom made the part. A big mama, she made a two-man family, a big good with championship. And I don't know if my mom got a, we were eating, and I saw my mom fight on a chip. And I was just 89 years old, and that's the first time I ever said anything. You know, you need a bottle. And I said, Mom, you have to make so much noise. And I looked at my mom, she was crying. And I looked at her, this is what's going to be in the song. I'll never forget that. And, you know, Mom got a lot of work. They take care of the baby and they grow up. I believe, I see it all. But what will it get me? My mom takes care of the neighbors and that is my family. So, congratulations tomorrow, mom, all your mom and grandma too. This song, I mean, it kind of sad, but it's good in the way. But,
it's not that it's not working. It's
same owner too?
Yes, a couple.
Sure, good to see all you smiling faces.
You didn't see what was going on.
I'd like to welcome each and every one of you. I'm not the best singer in the world, and at my age, I don't have much wind left, so I gasp for air once in a while, but this is for my Lord and Savior.
Amen. Amen.
And I don't mean to entertain you, but I sure hope you like it, the songs that I sing, because they have a lot of meaning. And I got a lot of them in there, but I don't do them the best. But I hope you'll like these. And I kind of, what would you give in exchange for your soul? You know, God is so good to us. He always treats us good, no matter what we do. He's the most forgiving God that we have. And He's always there for us. And He never said, I'll never leave you nor forsake you. And you're never alone, because goodness and mercy will follow you the rest of your life.
Amen.
So I'm going to try a couple of songs. Last week, my voice just didn't work with me, and I lost the tone to them, but I'm going to try to do better this week. What would you give for your soul, in exchange for your soul? Brother apart from the Savior today, risking your soul for the things that decay, what if today God would call you away? What would you give in exchange for your soul? What would you give in exchange? What would you give in exchange? What would you give in exchange for your soul? If God would call you away today, what would you give in exchange for your soul? Mercy is calling you, won't you give heed? Must if your Savior still tenderly plead? Risk out your soul, it is precious indeed. What would you give in exchange for your soul? What would you give in exchange? What would you give in exchange? What would you give in exchange for your soul? If God would call you away today, what would you give in exchange for your soul? More than silver and gold of this earth, more than all the jewels thy spirit is worth. God the Creator has given it birth. What would you give in exchange for your soul? What would you give in exchange? What would you give in exchange? What would you give in exchange for your soul? If God would call you away today, what would you give in exchange for your soul? What would you give in exchange for your soul?
Amen.
Thank
other one is the House of Gold. This is kind of a favorite of mine because it kind of touches on all of us in earth. Because we're always looking for the best, the mostest for the leastest. And you know, I always tell everybody that God gives us salvation. He says you'll live forever. But your choice is, where are you going to live at? And he's the most forgiving God.
Amen.
We're not perfect. But he knows when you do it intentionally, when you do it mistakenly. A house of gold. People steal, they cheat and they lie. For wealth and what it will buy. Don't they know that on judgment day that their gold and silver will melt away? I'd rather be in a deep dark grave and know that my soul was saved than live in this world in a house of gold and deny my God and doom my soul. Jesus said, come unto me, all breaks and chains, and set you free. I'll carry you home up on high, where you'll never die. I'd rather be in a deep dark grave and know my soul was saved than live in this house of gold and deny my God and lose my soul. What good is silver and gold to when your heart's not good and true? Sinner, hear me when I say, fall down on your knees and pray. Jesus died there on the cross so that this world would not be lost. Sinner, hear me when say, for someday you'll have to pay. I'd rather be in a deep dark grave and know my poor soul was saved than live in this world in a house of gold and deny my God and doom my soul. What good is silver and gold to if your heart's not good and true? Sinner, hear me when I say, fall down on your knees and pray. Fall down on your knees and pray. It's what we're all working and striving for. When we see God, I want to walk over heaven with you. And you know that day it's going to come. And from the looks of this old country and the world, it's coming soon. I tell everybody, I don't know if you know my Savior or not, but if you don't, get to know him.
Amen.
He's the best friend you'll ever have.
Amen.
And I might not do this one too good because I'm getting a little short. If I surveyed all the good things that come to me from above, if I could count all the blessings from the storehouse of heaven. I'd simply ask for favor of him beyond mortal skin, and I knew that he'd grant it again. I want to stroll over heaven with you some glad day, when all our troubles and headaches wash away, and we'll enjoy all the beauty when things are new. I want to stroll over heaven with you. Some places of beauty we long to see here below, but times and treasures have kept us from making plans, as you know. But come the morning of the rapture, together we shall stand anew, and we'll stroll over heaven with you. I want to stroll over heaven with you some glad day, when all our troubles and headaches vanish away, and we'll enjoy the beauty where all things are new. I want to stroll over heaven with you. I want to stroll over heaven with you.
The sound to the lyrics, but you know, God knows each one of our hearts. And when we put for him first in everything we do, we want to make everything we do all about him first. And he'll take care of us. You know, you're looking at one of the best blessed people that you'll ever meet. From all the medical conditions that I've had and my age, and I can still get around pretty good. And I love to sing to my Lord and Savior. At least I can do that to make him look good. Thank you, Jordan.
Thank you for your help. Now let's give them a hand for trying to get baby. The devil is working on you. You lost, devil.
You lost.
Here we go.
Don't look down.
But back in my memory, I can hear her every day. Oh, I hear the prayer that he prayed to God for her goodness every day. You're hoping that he just hear me say, Mama, I got saved. And he prayed, Lord, please save my children. I'm asking you today, Lord, please save my children.
Help!
familiar with? Well, kitchen?
Yeah.
Kitchen. Yes, sir. Yeah.
What's for supper?
Yeah, we're just, yeah, we're friends. This is my friend. We're both from Foster. And this is all Tim's doing. He's the one that told me about it. So. Krista wants to sing a song.
Knew that you'd be in great company because me, my wife, and my mother-in-law are all from Fostoria, too.
Well, that's good thing.
So you're more than welcome to come up. Tonight's open.
Appreciate you letting me sing a song. It's been a wonderful evening. You guys are a wonderful congregation here. It's a beautiful building. And what a sound system. What a terrific group. So thank you very much.
We won't follow it up except for now we ask for an offering for our singers that have come so far. That 2-hour drive here and that 2-hour drive back cost. So we're going to take up a love offering, and I'll pray over this love offering. If you'll bow your heads. Dear Heavenly Father, we ask that you bless this offering. May it be abundant to help our singers get back home and for their expenses. We've heard such great music and about to hear some more. We ask that you bless us and bless all of us as you already have. In Jesus Christ's holy name we pray. Amen and amen.
Thank you.
I guess it gets bypassed on me. All right, we're taking it all over the place. We'll call our singers up for their last portion, and then we'll. We got some mighty good videos back here.
Yeah. Let's give all those singers a great big hand.
All of heaven came down.
I
here, do you worry at all? Or is it just sometimes me? I try not to. Because back when all of that pandemic stuff was going on, you know, how you worried, will I have a job, will I not have a job, will I have food, will I, you know, all that worry stuff in your head. And God spoke to me one day, and he says, Brendan, if you're worrying, you're not trusting me. And if you're not trusting me, you're saying you don't have faith that I can take care of you. Wow, that was a big one. It was like a big smack over my head, but it got me thinking that I don't need to worry. He supplies all of my needs. He'll supply every one of your needs. Listen, as I sing this song, it says, worry ends where our faith begins.
Oh, what a day that will be.
Jesus I shall see when I look upon his face, the one who saved me by his grace, when he takes me by the hand and leads me through the promised land. What a day, glorious day that will be. Oh, what a day that will be when my Jesus I shall see, when I look upon his face, the one who saved me by his grace, when he takes me by the hand and leads me through the promised land. What a day, glorious day that will be. Oh, what a day, glorious day that will be.
When I stumbled there, I would humble down.
trouble, everything that's got a name. All the wealth I want, worth a thing. If it could still, I wouldn't take nothing from a journey now. There's nothing in the world that will ever take the place of God's love. Silver and gold can never buy mighty ties from above. When my soul needs a healing and I begin feeling his heart, I can say thank the Lord, I wouldn't take nothing for my journey now.
Well, I wouldn't take nothing for my journey now. I got a vision to heaven somehow. Oh, the devil takes me and he tries to turn me around. He's offered everything that's got a name, all the wealth I want. Worldly fame, if it could still, I wouldn't take nothing for my journey now. Well, I wouldn't take nothing for my journey now. I gotta make it to heaven somehow. Though the devil tempts me and he tries to turn me around. He's offered everything that's got a name, all the wealth I want. Worldly fame, if it could still, I wouldn't take nothing for my journey now. If it could still, I wouldn't take nothing for my journey.
Table back in the back when you go back there to eat, and then we're going to do one more song, and then we'll wait, maybe. Real quick, I want to talk to hold it. I need to hold one. I can't help not holding something besides the mic. But we do have a brand new CD that Jack is with us on. It's got good news on it. It's got that song, Who Is on the Lord's Side, The Love of Christ, that little bluegrass song. And he's got that song that we just did there, Wouldn't Take Nothing for My Journey Now.
I thought it said, I wouldn't take nothing for my Jersey cat.
No. But anyway, it's got a lot of good songs. It's got the three of us on that. Our newest one, we take a $20 donation for. If you buy two others, we'll throw two others in and for $30. And there is a Christmas you can pick from if you really wanted to. But these are 20, or you can get three of them for 30. We do take cash, check, and all credit cards. Okay, George, hang it up. Hold it up. Oh, come on. Don't make me work for it. Thank you. Isn't that better? This is Isaiah 40:31, Soar Like an Eagle. I've got this in medium through 3X, 2X. And then that one over there that Jack's got, hold it up, Jack. It says Forgiven, John 3:16. And I've only got that in large and extra large. And I got one more little thing I want to show you before we sing our last song. I like this plaque. It says, stand for the flag, kneel for the cross. I love this. These are 10, t-shirts are 20. We do have a big variety of hats back there for 10 each. That's what helps keeps us on the road. Not just, we appreciate the love offerings, that really helps us, but it takes a lot out there, and God knows we're not in it for money, because if we were, we'd have quit probably 20 years ago, but that's just not the way it is. We're going to do a song. You know what? Some of you don't know this, but I got a pastor friend and his family that showed up tonight. We were at his church last Sunday.
Yeah.
He was on vacation. So he made a special effort to come over and see us. And we're going to do a song here. And if you want to come help us, you're more than welcome. It's just going to be short, sweet.
If you do a good job, we'll replace Jack.
Hey. So he comes up here, I feel like it's the Jolly Green Giant. I feel like I'm so small.
Just say, I'll walk away for a little bit. I'll sit back here, see.
No, that's okay. Let me get to my other page here. So we're going to try singing this, boys.
Do what I know, okay?
Well, I know here, most everybody knows this song. I'm just going to push it up there. Have you ever heard the song, I'll Fly Away?
Oh, yes.
Well, let everybody stand up.
And let's do this. It's just short and sweet, but it's got such a good meaning in it. Listen as we sing it. Hospital, and they said, your heart's in distress, you're ready for a massive. And he ended up with the open heart surgery. And you know what? Many years later, look what God can do. That's a God thing. Let's have one more from the church, one of them.
Sorry. I had a stroke in 2001. I was baking pies for Christmas. And they told me that I live with my son-in-law and my daughter, and they told me, they said, you need to go to the hospital. And I said, no, I'll go, you know, when I get my pies done. Mark's sister is a nurse, and she came down, and she said, no, Mom, you're having a stroke. You need to go now. And again, I said, when I get my pies done.
She turned on the oven.
She said, we'll take care of the pies. You're going to the hospital. If I had not went, I know God was in control of that whole situation.
Yes.
Because there's only 3% survivor rate and the type of stroke I had. Amen. In my life.
And my daughter-in-law had my son go to the hospital.
Thank God, because people don't realize sometimes it's a matter of time. But you know what? God wasn't finished with me yet. Same way he wasn't finished with him yet. We got more of a work to do. We got people to be able to come in and be saved and be ready to go to heaven. Okay, let's do one more song here. George, I don't know if I can get that fixed. That's a hard one. We're going to do one more here. He says it's a happy Goodman song, and he wants it.
Christ has drawn our hungry bear up beyond blue skies. It must be so wondrously fair, never seen a mortal eye. We know soon he's coming again from his heavenly throne. We shall leave his earthly domain when he comes to claim his own. Then hurry up, get ready to go. Then hurry up, no time to be slow. If you want to ride on the glory cloud with the Savior and his chosen crowd, you better hurry up, get ready to go. Give your heart to Jesus today. Oh, why longer refuse? Let him wash your sins all away. He's the only one to choose. Do not wait until it's too late. Let him be your true guide. Enter in at first bright gate, innocent and open wide. Better hurry up, get ready to go. Better hurry up, no time to be slow.
If you're gonna ride on the golden cloud with the Savior and his chosen bride,
better hurry up, Get ready to go. You better hurry up. Get ready to go. You better hurry up. No time to be slow.
If you're gonna ride on the holy cloud, with the simulator slowly crying,
you better hurry up. Get ready to go. You better hurry up. Hurry up. Hurry up. Hurry up.
Is Latter Rain.
Yes.
And I ask for your kindness and your courteousness. Our singers have 2 hours to drive home. If you would please hold off and let them get to the food first so they can have something to eat before they go home.
Amen.
And I'm telling you, my mother-in-law, my wife, and
Sandy,
and Tim, I'll give Tim credit to, and Harold. We've been cooking all day long. It's Mexicana, and I'm telling you, there's apple fritters down, or Mexican, apple, yeah, and cold beef, and tacos and chicken mole. Oh my word. But I'd like to have everybody bow their heads. Dear Heavenly Father, we thank you for this glorious evening to be able to praise, honor, and glorify you. We ask that you bless this food with your mercy and grace. We also ask for blessings for each and every one here for safe travel home. We ask all this in your glorious and loving name. Amen and amen.
If anybody would like some prayer, would you make your way on up here? And we're going to follow the scripture that says, you know, come to the elders of the church, and we're going to anoint you with oil, and we're going to pray over you. And I love to pray. I love to pray for people. I trust Jesus and believe in him completely.
George Trump.
Thank you.